Hi to friends, hari ini aku mau membahas suatu aplikasi yang seru banget. So, karena semua orang lagi main TikTok, termasuk aku, cuman aku nggak bikin konten sih, aku tim pemantau aja. Jadi, belakangan ini ada suatu aplikasi yang rame banget di TikTok. Beberapa hari yang lalu, aku lagi liat TikTok kan, aku scroll, tiba-tiba ketemu postingan orang. Jadi dia sama teman-temannya gitu ketemu koper yang isinya mayat.
Guys, we found it. That's okay, that to me.
Gabby, go. I'll hold your stuff. I don't know.
Bro. Wait, open it.
Open it.
Open it.
Sweet.
It stinks, y'all.
It washed up. It's
oh. Oh. Okay, so she's calling the police so we can see if it's actually a dead body or it's just food.
What do I found a suitcase on the
point in Alpha Beach. Yeah, here's the crime scene.
Yap, dan banyak yang bilang nggak cuma satu koper yang ditemuin. Ternyata banyak koper yang ditemuin dan langsung masuk news. Dan memang ternyata di daerah itu lagi ada serial killer atau pembunuh berantai. Serem kan? Nah, mereka bilang mereka tuh lagi main Randonautica atau orang sana nyebutnya Randonautic. Oke, apa itu Randonautica? Jadi, Randonautica adalah sebuah aplikasi mobile. Ada yang bilang ini aplikasi dan ada juga yang bilang kalau ini adalah game. Ramenya memang di bulan Mei kemarin ini dan memang baru dirilis pada tahun 2020 ini. Aku penasaran dong, kemudian aku cari tahu. Websitenya kalau dibuka tampilannya kayak gini. Dan kalau di search di Google kayak gini. Randonautica was created to send a randonaut outside of their day-to-day routine by using a quantum random number generator to derive a coordinate to journey to. Nah lo, bingung kan? Aku bingung banget karena aku nggak ngerti yang namanya quantum. Aku bukan anak fisika sih. Tapi karena video itu di TikTok, aku jadi kayak nyari kan ternyata banyak banget yang mainin Randonautica. Mereka Randonautic disebutnya adalah Randonauts, orang-orang yang main aplikasi ini. Yang aku temuin experience-nya tuh absurd banget, seru-seru sih. Yuk kita lihat beberapa videonya.
What is that?
What the fuck are those goats?
No, it's like somebody making creepy noises.
We have to go. Are they killing them?
Meh.
Are they murdering the fucking
goats? Meh. Meh.
Simi is now communing with the goat spirits. There's two of them. She's now the goat whisperer. What am I doing here? Please explain. I'm scared.
Yeah, let's leave. There's a fucking chair.
Aplikasi ini seru banget sih, terutama untuk para petualang. Jiwa-jiwa petualang pasti seneng banget sama aplikasi ini. Somehow ngerasa serem aja gitu. Dan setelah kalian lihat video, pasti kalian mikir, anjir, apaan tuh, itu apaan? Jadi, cara kerjanya aplikasi ini, setelah kita download, kita set lokasi kita. Setelah itu, Quantum Random Number Generator bakalan ngasih kita pinpoint atau titik gitu, lokasi tempat yang bakalan kita tuju, semacam koordinat gitu. Kayak kalian bayangin semacam kalau misalnya kalian mau ke resto atau mau jalan-jalan kemana tapi kalian nggak tahu how to get there, kan pasti bakalan menggunakan maps atau Waze kan. Nah kayak gitu, kita dikasih koordinat tujuan kita. Nah mereka ngacak lokasinya dari mana? Mereka menggunakan Quantum Random Number Generator ini. Tapi yang bikin keren adalah kalian harus set your intention dulu. Apa sih set your intention itu? Maksudnya kalau di Indonesia kan adalah kita harus menentukan niat dan tujuan kita. Gimana caranya? Bisa dengan dari hati, bisa dengan dari pikiran, dan bisa kalian ngomongin atau ngucapin secara lantang, kenceng-kenceng gitu. Misalnya ya, kalian download nih, set lokasi kalian. Kemudian kalian tentuin kalian mau experience yang seperti apa. Misalnya kalian mau lihat warna kuning, kalian bisa ngomong dalam hati, ah gue pengen lihat warna kuning, atau di pikiran. Atau kalian juga bisa ngomong kencang-kencang, gue pengen lihat warna kuning nih. Nanti kalian bakalan dikasih koordinat. Begitu kalian ke sana, kalian bakal ketemu benda yang berwarna kuning di sana. Atau misalnya kalian pengen ngelihat anjing, nah ya udah, kalian ke sana, di lokasi itu kalian bakalan bertemu anjing. Kayak gini contohnya.
We are randonauting right now and we are manifesting. What are we doing?
Red and yellow.
Red and yellow. We'll see how it turns out. What the fuck? This balloon, red and yellow. Right. Point number two. We are manifesting butterflies. So it brought us to these trails, and we've lived in this town for like what?
Our
whole
lives.
Fucking lives, and we had no idea there were trails here. So when we said butterflies, we meant like iridescent colors, so stay tuned.
It's like a quarter of a mile. Like we were not that far
away. So she keeps zooming in and the point keeps getting farther away. We did find this pond though, and as we were walking, I got a call from an unknown number, so that was weird. Yup, and literal bones, literal bones. The ground is like covered in fur, like all of this is fur.
Nah, yang rame di TikTok itu, karena satu udah nyoba, terus yang lain kan pada ikut coba kan. Mereka ada kesamaan, mereka pengen experience yang creepy atau horror gitu. Nah, makanya mereka dapetnya ya ngalaman yang horror-horror.
Okay, so this randonauting app just brought us to this creepy town. And honestly, when we saw this, we should have turned around and left. We continued up the mountain though, and there's always abandoned cars and nobody around. At this point, we're definitely trespassing. We couldn't even really turn around at this point because the road was so narrow and it was such a steep drop off on the other side. But we were kind of intrigued at how creepy this was, even though it was getting dark really quick, and next thing we know the sun had gone down and the moon came out, giving it just more of a creepy vibe. But we had the pin pulled up, we were so close to it,
dude,
and this
what
happened.
The fuck is...
I don't know how to explain this. We're the only ones
shit.
Around and a random rock falls. I think that was a sign that we should leave. But
where did that come from?
We kept going. Everything about this place was just giving me really bad vibes, and when I looked into here and saw this, as soon as I realized it's some sort of face, we took off running. I don't know what it is with this town, why there's all these abandoned cars and no people and mannequins in the window, but I'm deleting this app.
You got scared.
No, because I heard Natalie saying Jamie even when the windows were locked.
No, I didn't say anything.
You didn't say Jamie?
No.
Makanya kalau misalnya kalian takut sama hal-hal yang kayak gitu, set your mind happy thoughts aja biar kalian juga menemukan hal yang membuat happy gitu. Kayak gini nih. Ada juga yang kayak pengen kucing gitu, terus tiba-tiba kayak dia ngeliat aja di TikTok ada aplikasi Randonautica.
Okay, if you have seen any TikToks about the Randonautica app, I'm shook. You need to keep listening. My boyfriend and I were supposed to get this kitten today, and my mom said no, so of course we were really sad about it. And then I saw a TikTok about the Randonautica app, and I was like, we need to do that because I really want a kitten. So, this is the location it gave us, as you can see. It's 5 minutes from where we live, kind of in the middle of nowhere, but there was easy roads to get there. And there was a gate blocking us from getting where we needed to be. Then when I was turning the car around, I kid you not,
come here, buddy.
This kitten was there.
Oh, ada juga yang dapat pengalaman religius di sini. Kita lihat.
I'm literally shaking right now. Sorry, I just got finished crying, but story time. So, I tried that Randonautica thing that everyone's been talking about, like Randonauting, just to try it out because I have nothing else to do. And the app asks you to like think about an intent, like why you're about to go to the location that it gives you. So it's basically manifesting. So if you think really, really hard about, oh, I want to find love, or oh, you know, whatever, then you're supposed to like think about it. I literally just thought to myself, happiness, because that's something that I want, obviously. And I've been having a really hard time finding that in like these past couple months, I guess. Didn't type anything into the map, I just thought it, and then it just gave me a location. As soon as I saw it, I just, oh my. And this is where it took me. This is the exact spot it took me to, and there's a sign, and I'm not gonna start crying again. But yeah, the sign and the church, I can't explain it. It's insane, like, it's amazing.
Jadi kalau misal kalian mikir yang happy-happy aja, ya kalian nggak akan menemukan hal yang serem, tergantung dari pemikiran kalian. Keren kan? Aplikasi ini tuh bekerja berdasarkan our minds atau pikiran kita. Jadi ini lebih dari sekedar kebetulan. Segala sesuatu dalam hidup itu tercipta dari energi. Dan pikiran kita, energi juga. Nah, ini yang ngasih kita lokasi acak untuk kita explore. Kita akan dikasih pilihan. Attractor, avoid, anomaly. Pilihan pertama atau attractor itu adalah tempat di mana quantum point atau energi di sana tuh tinggi banget. Avoid adalah tempat di mana quantum point atau energinya tuh low, bahkan hampir nggak ada. Dan anomaly adalah perpaduan antara attractor dan avoid. Jadi kayak kalau attractor kan extreme high gitu, kalau avoid kan extreme low. Jadi perpaduan menjadi anomaly.
So we decided to play Rando Nautica, and it took us to this random detention center. It's just kind of a dead end back here, and immediately it rerouted us, and she'd got a text from a random ass number that said, "Are you real?" And we decided to come back to check it out, and it just says real.
Pee pee poo poo.
Ada juga yang punya pengalaman-pengalaman aneh gitu ya, pas dia main-main ini, mereka ketemu anjing putih.
Oh, so I did that random Nautica app, and let me tell you something, it took me, well not me, technically my sister did it, and it took me here, watch.
This random dog here just staring, and it's not moving, what the fuck, and it took us to the tower.
So basically, download this app if you're bored, because I honestly didn't think anything creepy or weird out of the normal was gonna happen, and it did. So yeah.
Orang yang komen katanya menurut tradisi Hispanic tuh kalau misalnya ada anjing putih berarti ada angel yang jaga mereka supaya tetap selamat. Tapi kalau misalnya ada anjing hitam itu artinya ada bahaya gitu.
My boyfriend and I decided to go on a Randonaut adventure, and you guys, it gets so creepy. Do not do this alone. We ended up driving through this really weird street. There was no one there. And we also ended up walking a little bit. I was obviously not prepared for this since I was wearing Crocs. And my feet got so dusty. At this point, I was really skeptical. I didn't really want to go further, but I was there already. Like, where are we? This was weird, but it gets weirder. We found a huge bird's nest. Like, what is this? Or at least that's what I thought it was. And then there was this path. I don't know what it is. If you know what it is or what it means, comment down below. I don't know if it's like witchcraft or something. I'm scared. And then there was like a bunch of random stuff inside in the middle and a bunch of rocks. So basically it led us to a big bird's nest.
Biasanya sih ke hutan-hutan gitu ya mereka ya. Mereka tuh pada nggak yakin tapi tetap pergi gitu. Karena udah nanggung kali ya. Dan ternyata menurut komen yang aku baca, ini adalah labirin untuk meditasi katanya. Jadi kita lewatin treknya, terus kita fokus sama doa kita. Tradisi orang kan beda-beda ya. Kepercayaan orang juga beda-beda. Kita harus menghormati setiap kepercayaan orang yang berbeda. Okay, back to topic. Bahkan gak jarang nih kalau kamu lagi bingung sama sesuatu, aplikasi ini tuh kayak bisa ngasih kamu petunjuk kayak gini nih.
So, I just really made a really, like, difficult life decision to give up my dream school, like my top tier dream school that I got into, and to go to my state school just because of corona and stuff. Whole ordeal, doesn't matter. But I decided to go randonauting. You know, that whole trend that's going on TikTok. And I went with the intent to, you know, get closure to make sure that I, like, made the right decision. And by the way, the decision is to go to Kansas University. And let me show you where I fucking... So I got taken to this weird-ass park. You know, weird. And at first I saw this horse, I'm like, what the fuck? Why? But a KU is literally carved into the grass.
Jadi di sini cewek ini tuh kayak bilang dia tuh galau gitu. Dia ragu-ragu apakah benar pilihan dia memilih KU ini, Kansas University. Dan ternyata pas dia main Randonautica, dia dikasih pinpoint lokasi gitu. Pas dia datang ke sana, ada tulisan KU. Bahkan ada juga yang kayak selamat dari kecelakaan gitu nih, kita lihat ya bareng-bareng.
Okay, so for people who don't know, this is Randomortica. It's an app and it gives you locations to go to. It's like a fate thing. My friend told me about it and I thought nothing about it. So I downloaded it and I went tonight to my two locations. This is where it gets weird. So I went to the first location and nothing. I went to the second one because I was like, I feel like I have to go there. And like, so it's 7 minutes away from me. So obviously this is what the app looks like. And it gives you like, where do you want to go? So I went and the woman, like, it gave me a specific house. She came out of the house and smiled at me and was staring at me. It was weird. I was gonna leave and my message to the app wasn't sending. It kept saying like, here, it was like, failed to send, try again. So I stayed for an extra 5 minutes. Like, I stayed. I felt like I had to stay. After I left, a police car drove past me and I made a joke about it to her because we were on call. And I carried on driving the way I would home and like for part two.
Part two.
So we already know I tried to send the report, it didn't work. We already know I saw a police car and joked about it. Because the report didn't send, I didn't leave for an extra 5 minutes. I started noticing that the police car was actually going towards my house. And I was driving my normal way home, like I didn't go out of my way to follow the police car or anything like that. And the road that I came down to get there, the road I was going to go back up, had been blocked off by an ambulance and three police cars. This was me after I pulled over in a safe location and had realised what I had just seen. I propped my phone up to show my friend what I was seeing. That's when we realised that if I had left my location 5 minutes earlier, that would have been me. I watched them put the guy in the ambulance. I drove around to the top of the street to see if I could see what was going on. And there had been a car accident, a big car accident. I'm glad she made me wait 5 minutes. Like if you want to hear more on this.
Kalau aja tadi dia langsung cabut, dia pasti celaka gitu. Pasti dia yang kecelakaan. Tapi karena dia nunggu, kayak selamat dari kecelakaan itu. Gila, gue merinding coy. Yeah, kayak gitu deh. Banyak yang bilang juga aplikasi ini tuh kayak ngubah takdir kamu gitu. Dan macam-macam sama aplikasi ini katanya gitu. Pengalaman orang beda-beda dan aneh-aneh sih. Jadi rata-rata yang main aplikasi ini setelah dikasih lokasi tuh kayak pada kok bisa gitu loh.
If you like to be spooked, listen. Rando Knotting. It's an app you download. It's called Rando Knot. What is it? Rando Knot gives you QRPs, quantum random points. What are quantum random points, bitch? Let me explain that to you. Quantum random points are high points of energy and power near you. Attractors have a lot of energy, voids don't have as much. So if you really want to get spooked.
Kalau misalnya kalian penasaran sama pengalaman orang banyak banget yang main Randonautica ini gara-gara TikTok dan gara-gara lockdown kayaknya ya. Kemarin itu pas pandemi COVID-19 kan banyak negara yang lockdown kan. Jadi kayak mereka nyari aktivitas dan ketemulah Randonauting. Sampai website-nya pun crash karena banyak banget yang main. Okay, pros and cons. Ternyata banyak pro dan kontra nih di aplikasi ini. Dan beberapa orang berasumsi kalau aplikasi ini tuh not safe, nggak aman. Kalian punya banget resiko untuk diculik. Dan bahkan juga banyak yang berasumsi kalau misalnya aplikasi ini tuh bekerja sama dengan dark web untuk human trafficking.
Oh shit. I have four.
Took us to this
place.
Shit. Hello?
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 Let's go. Okay, let's start walking. Dinah, that's fucking creepy.
Okay. Yeah. Dinah, please hurry. Let's go.
Why do we just go to this fucking quantum point and this whole fucking person is Sky? Oh my fucking god, bitch, I can't.
What if the person shows up in my rear view camera?
No, bitch, I can't.
Bahkan ada yang bilang jangan-jangan creator-nya kayak emang ngeset lokasinya sengaja gitu untuk nyulik orang, untuk human trafficking. Jadi pas kita datang udah ada penculiknya lagi nunggu. Tapi ada juga yang ngebela, katanya ini kan berdasarkan intention kita kan. Jadi lokasinya itu karena pakai quantum random number generator acak gitu. Nggak semua orang dikasih lokasi yang sama dan kita nggak bisa ke lokasi yang sama dua kali. Jadi it's totally safe kata orang ya. Cuman banyak juga yang skeptical sama aplikasi ini. Cuman memang ya kalian harus hati-hati aja kalau misalnya bayangin jadi mereka gitu. Terus main hutan gitu, tiba-tiba ketemu orang jahat dan diculik. Makanya, kata creator dari aplikasi ini, kalau misalnya kalian mau randonoring, kalian gak boleh sendiri dan kalian gak boleh main malam-malam biar lebih aman. Jadi pas terang aja, pas siang-siang dan rame-rame biar less scary dan lebih aman. Setahu aku sih ya, setahu aku, correct me if I'm wrong, tapi orang Indonesia tuh belum ada yang main aplikasi ini. Baru orang luar negeri. Nggak tahu apakah karena di sini belum nge-hits atau memang servernya nggak nyampe atau gimana, aku nggak tahu sih. Aku pun belum berani nyoba meskipun mungkin sudah masuk Indonesia ya. Gimana menurut kalian? Apa kalian berani nyoba? Kalau misalnya kalian berani nyoba, please banget, play it safe. Jangan mikir yang aneh-aneh, positive thinking aja. Emang kalau misalnya kalian memang penyuka tantangan dan suka yang horror-horror, ya silakan. Tapi saya tidak merekomendasikan untuk main sendiri dan main malam-malam gitu ya. Karena mungkin aplikasi ini bisa dimanfaatkan oleh pihak-pihak yang kurang bertanggung jawab. Mendingan biar amannya, kalian nontonin aja pengalaman-pengalaman orang yang main randonautica. Di YouTube banyak, di TikTok banyak, di Reddit apalagi. So, that's all for Real Talk edisi randonautica. Semoga bermanfaat dan hope you like it. Sampai ketemu lagi di video aku berikutnya. Bye!